again, Ike and oil. Just don't mix, you know? Not a wallet-friendly combination either. Gas prices this morning are up for a fifth day in a row. AAA reports a jump of almost 6 cents nationwide from Saturday into Sunday to an average now of $3.79 a gallon. All of those refineries Ike shut down are still closed. That's going to strain fuel supplies. And experts say prices could end up substantially higher. Substantially higher. Josh, that's what the experts say.
Yeah.
And the experts are never wrong.
Oh, is that true? Well, maybe we're about to find out.
Yeah,
we can reality check them next weekend. How's that? I mean, it's the talk of the nation. This is what everybody's talking about. And this is just some iReports behind me, people complaining about the massive spike in gas prices near them. I'm going to bring in now Kevin Kerr, editor of the Global Commodities Alert. Hey there, Kevin.
Hey, Josh. How are you?
Good. Listen, I want to start off with this. I'm hearing every possible explanation for what's happened since Ike. I'm hearing that it's just people panicking and buying up all the gas. I'm hearing allegations of price gouging. And I'm hearing, hey, don't blame the retailers. They're paying extra to the refineries. What happened to cause these massive spikes in the gas price?
Yeah, it's a little bit of everything, you know, and I wouldn't blame the retailers. I agree with that because the retailers are afraid they're going to have to pay these wholesale prices come Monday. All those costs trickle down right to us at the pump, and unfortunately, the retailers have to pass it on to us.
But, Kevin, there must be some cases of price gouging. I mean, if someone gets to a gas station and sees it go up 80 or 90 cents right in front of them, and it's not like that down the block, they're going to suspect that. How can someone know? If they get to a gas station, they see a huge price, how do you know if you're being gouged or not?
Well, first of all, you know, since Katrina, there are pretty stringent laws in place. Government's taking a very close look at this, and local governments really well. Really, the way you can look at it is look around the other gas stations in the area. Are the prices comparable, or is this a specific station? That would be a good gauge of what's going on.
Well, let's talk about the panic factor, because we knew for a long time the storm was coming, and there have been other hurricanes in the past, and I don't ever remember so many people saying 50 or 60 or 80 cent jumps like that. Why the panic factor more this time?
Yeah, it has been an extreme panic factor, and I think that's because what people experienced during Katrina and Rita, and there was a lot of fear factor here. I think supplies will be crimped, though. We have to remember we have an 8-year low for gasoline supplies, and we have this hurricane moving into the center of energy production for the nation. All these 9 refineries that are down in that area or could be down for a while if the electrical grid stays down, and that's bad news.
Well, let's talk a little bit about the future, because I do want to look ahead. Now, we don't actually know yet what's going to happen with these key oil installations, and as I was telling you all yesterday, several of the biggest oil refineries in the country are right there in Texas. 13 to 26 were shut down even before Ike. What do we need to find out to start to gauge what the impact is going to be on gas prices in the coming weeks or months due to Ike?
Well, you know, the bottom line is we're going to have to wait and see what the electrical grid looks like. These refineries require a lot of electricity. We're not going to get accurate damage reports until we know if they can get electrical up and running these facilities. Once we have that, and we hear from Exxon and BP, who have 2 of the biggest refineries down there, then we'll get a better picture of how bad this could be. This storm reminds me, and I've been looking at it all night, of Alicia back in 1983. Refineries were shut down for several months. A situation like that could drive gasoline prices much, much higher.
Well, you know, that's just the kind of news that our viewers want to wake up to if they just turn on the TV first thing.
The good news is, you know, the loss of life wasn't greater, could be a problem going forward for gas supplies.
And the evacuations were taken seriously and the human cost was minimized, absolutely, and I'm glad that you pointed that out. Listen, Kevin Kerr, it's so good to have you. We're going to be talking to you a lot in the coming weeks because I'm telling you, people are talking to us nonstop about these crazy gas prices. We're hoping to see some of that subside today. Kevin, thanks a lot. TJ,
thank you.
Hoping to see some of that.